Hey guys, it's Roy Purpose, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Little Pro Karma World. So, the off fight. He picked up wins in the league. He got past the last Champions League game as well. Well, I simmed the last Champions League game because, of course, I'd already qualified. In this episode, I have a League Cup quarterfinal against Sunderland, and then I will have a league game against Manchester United at Old Trafford. But first, it is Sunderland, it is the quarterfinal of the Capital One Cup.
Well, this is a real shuffling
lineup. Some money.
Place of Vito Mannoni, who's injured.
Actually, all players are playing for moves elsewhere. You can see, I did recall Brito because I made a mistake in the summer loaning him to Chelsea. I forgot that Chelsea won't play him. And that's the whole point of player going out alone, they get some first team football, not play me whenever. If I wanted him to just play in the cup, then he may as well stay here. So hopefully he'll get another look in the January transfer window, which is coming up. I have only 5 games remaining before that window opens.
There goes the cross. They took no chances there.
Normally I do 3 matches in the next episode, but I'm gonna just stick to 2 and I'll go into the window.
Mate, you got a few more chances in the box with the bounce of the ball and what have you.
Patrick Van Aanholt.
All my players are, the players who are leaving are already listed for
Rodwell.
Loan or for sale. Or transfer listed as it were. So, hopefully the players, mostly the midfielders, actually, they are all midfielders except for the goalkeeper. I'm hoping he'll get a loan as well. But yeah, all my midfielders are playing for loans or trying to attract new clubs. King Niles. I shouldn't have signed him. I really may. I don't normally make a mistake, but I did make a mistake on that occasion. I thought Aiden Niles would be a good signing, you know, a rotational player. I have just so many midfielders. I mean, Porto is probably a better choice for our future choice.
He's cut out that pass.
Yeah, it's just, there's no point to have Aiden Niles. So if I can somehow, I just want to make a profit, so even if it's 1,000 profit, any profit will do. Just a huge mistake on my part, and I'm enough to admit that I did make a mistake at signing Niles. I don't normally make mistakes with my signing. Normally a good sign. Normally I'm thinking, okay, this guy. He wouldn't be calling the signing a mistake if this were a secondary career. It's like, hey, Niles is
Max Gradle.
a rotational player or a first team player, depending on who you do the tour. Okay. For Liverpool, he's not at that level, and with other players in that position. Better for his own career if he doesn't stay here.
Ball has gone back to Sunderland.
And moves on to our club. Hopefully. I will try to get a profit. I won't be heartbroken if I don't, because I have loads of money in the bank, and the board won't get angry if I don't make a profit, because I'm pretty sure I can make a profit on some of the players that I sold, who were bought by Brendan Rodgers. So, there's that.
Two.
There's that.
Having a little game of their own here.
There's Brannigan. He's one who looks like Burnley club. And press. Going through. Oh, he buries it! That will get you attention for sure. Ryan with his second goal of the competition. Probably going to be his last game for Liverpool. I don't plan to play him, even if he does stay. Be better for his career if he does move on.
Place in the semi-final, not yet.
Some of them playing well. Over. They've kept the scoreline at 1-0. Actually, they just managed to get to 1-0, so they were very unlucky not to keep it at 0. Or maybe I didn't actually get
it. He's shut off now. The ball's loose. Goalkeeper made the save, but he couldn't hold it.
I went for a shot there. Well,
as blocks go, that's a good one. Max Gray,
who actually knows how to do his job. No.
That's
a... Silly me, forgot who I was up against there. I was probably getting confused because Manuel came from something. I just assume they don't teach you how to play in goal for something when you play for something. But then again, I remember, but Damon doesn't come from something. Dang it, Manuel, I didn't hear.
And now they might break out.
Not sure why I'm trying to
jostle the opponent off his stride.
Anyway,
EA Sports,
my random comments aside,
Sunderland, they'll be hosting
them. Brilliant. Yeah, really looking forward to this defensive work there right now.
Excellent passing, great interplay.
If I had another option, I'd sell you. He's been pissing me off in real life. Not so much in the game. Brilliant in game, but in real life.
And here's the head.
Frustrating me to all ends.
Well, we're at the time of the game where the strikers get taken off, whether they've played well or not, Alan.
Who did Sunderland just bring on?
And perhaps you wouldn't want to be either.
LeBron Santos and LeBron Marvelous. Okay. I saw 16. I thought that might be, I'm not even mention the name of the player, because the fucker deserves burn fucking hell. Well, how he only got 10 years, he should get life, is beyond me.
Manchester United in the next match in the Barclays Premier League. I think they could coast home in this one. Rodwell. Definitely in an attacking frame of mind. Look at the throw.
Busting fucking asshole.
There's the ball in. Great goal!
Anyway. Disregarding that horrible person and his horrible conduct,
We can see a slightly different...
Right across behind Miles. Beautifully headed in by Iheanacho. And it's 2-0.
Catamol. That is a cheap piece of play to give the ball away like that. This could be a chance.
3. Yeah, it is 3. Straight away, it's 3. Iheanacho under absolutely no pressure. He pretty much had all day. Running in as a goal and an assist to his name now. He got away from Fernando. And he slid it past. Just Pantelimon, who didn't seem to have a chance. So that is welcome. 1-0 to 3-0 in a matter of seconds. Well, in a minute, actually. Now, Iheanacho, who was already the top goal scorer in this competition, and before these two goals, is now chasing a hat trick.
Lost his marker cleverly.
So, Brennigan wins a corner.
Well, a corner to come because of that deflection. Punched away by the goalkeeper.
Demon punches clear.
Shots on here. Managed to stop the ball going forward with that block. They line up for the corner.
That's how I recognize that player's name. And whoever just came on for Sunderland there. Must be new.
And in goes the cross.
Maybe he's a region of some sort.
Cross is blocked. Corner coming up.
Looks like he's playing it left, perhaps? No. Ooh, Niles with a fantastic volley, but cleared off the line by, I think it was, yeah, Matthews. I think that's Matthews in real life currently playing for Celtic. If it's the Matthews I think it is, it might be a different Matthews. Great sack, and it's by New Matthews. He can't run through.
Adam Matthews.
Yeah, A. Matthews, it must be. Oh, what a goal from Gradel! Where did he pull that from?
What a volley that is. Certainly the best we've seen out here today, and the keeper clawing at thin air.
Just a reminder, 3-1 it is now, the scorer. Well, that's the quarter-final over with. They're through, and they're through into the semi-final.
That is... Granted, I don't like conceding goals, but that's a hell of a goal to concede. Now, if you're gonna concede a goal, it may as well be a spectacular one. That's probably easily the best goal of the game, considering I scored 3. That's saying something. Spurs are also through. Who else is in the competition? Everton, West Brom, Sheffield United, and Man City. Logic would dictate that City are going to beat Sheffield United and maybe Everton would be past West Brom? I don't know. We'll see. That one might be closer than I think. But City, they should beat Sheffield United, but then again, there's a difference between should and will, well especially in FIFA. Thank you. Well, I got Spurs, so whoever won the other two semifinals are playing each other. So it's either City versus Everton, or City versus West Brom, or it could be Sheffield United versus the other those teams. It's City and West Brom. West Brom won the winners over Everton. City did win against Sheffield United. Same scoreline I beat Sunderland by. So ironic. Coincidence. Playing Manchester United. Not in the top 7, Man United. The 10th. Wow. Didn't realize they were that low. Brilliant. Send them further down the fucking table. Sink these clowns. Whoa. I'm not. That's still Alberto Moreno. Oh. It knows I don't want to play Alberto Moreno. It knows I don't. If it still plays Alberto Moreno, yeah, here we go. So. Valencia. Completely different players.
Hello once again, I'm Martin Tyler and this is Old Trafford.
Sure, I probably meant to say completely
different. Great to watch this Liverpool team. Look at the amount of goals they've scored. Top scorers.
Well, they play such an open, expansive game. It does leave them vulnerable at times, but they've just been outscoring the opposition.
Well, it's Liverpool against
also been trying to keep the undefeated streak alive.
Alex Ferguson came down from Scotland to try and change that, and he did. Manchester United, obviously, in the last decade of the last century, the first decade of this century. He got
I thought Valdez was in. They'd keep it there for a bit longer. Neymar, who's 4 goals ahead of.
Shuffled their pack today, Manchester United. Victor Valdez starts. Phil Jones starts with Chris Smalling in central defence.
It was almost Correa. Who got the last touch on that? Was it Shaw? Well, Bale was running towards it, so this is
what it was. They've got plenty of goals with two strikers.
Nathaniel Pine.
Now he's looking
at Ricardo Rodriguez.
Coutinho!
That didn't work as I planned.
Ricardo
Rodriguez. Tillemans! Tactically has all this. Correa. Bale. Oof! The deflection almost took it in. Valdez. That's the, I think, is lucky goal. But it did go wide, because if it had been on target, it would have gone in, because he didn't even try. Dive to make sure it was going in. He manipulated that. Tillemans way over the park. Marco Royce. Oh, brilliant. Correa's wide. Getting the chances, just not getting the shots on target.
And it's now with Liverpool.
Forte.
Marco Royce.
Royce the tackle from Varela. and Blinkett's there before my, I think it's Coutinho, who's there.
That's safely away.
Yes. Neymar, Rain, it's 1-0, he's not offside. I thought for a second there he was going to be offside, but he's not.
There's a real gap between these two sides, reflected in the recent goal. But in terms of form, you'd have called it even.
Brain in the right place at the right time. Absolutely no one is paying any attention to him. Only after he's kicked the ball is smiling like, oh shit. Brain in acres of space, and that is his fourth goal of the season. Oh. Who you expect to get four goals? He sent back. Pretty sure that's the most.
No shots at all, so
any of my defenders have gotten in a season. I think three was the previous best in like season one. And for him at the other end does his defensive duties. So he's scoring at one end, and he's denying at the other.
Look at this too many times because it's middle of the goal. It's a decent height for him.
Oh shit! It's out for, I think it's another corner. Yep.
A goalkeeper who's asserted himself from the corner. The defenders love that. I think any football fan will say, when the rain comes down like it's coming down now, it's coming
straight to Valdez. Brilliant.
Doesn't it? And I always used to like it because it quite
Coutinho.
Often. You've got a few more chances in the box with the bounce of the ball and what have you.
Coutinho's gone through. The white ball is good. Was planned, they managed to get it anyway.
Able to make
I third. They threw a ball in the war. It's planned, but the team wins it back. And gives it straight to Ashley Young, brilliant. Who gives it straight to Laporte, fouls Laporte. And that should end the ping pong session for the moment. Dinamats. Foul by Nagolin. Was he taking? Ref, if you'd like to give him a yellow card.
Free giving the free kick taker every chance with getting the wall back the right distance.
Yo, let me. Let's see, is Royce right footed? Yes, he is. Okay, Marco. Ooh! It was not far off. It hit the post. A little bit in. And if I move, if I put a little more.
Yeah,
if I had turned a little more before shooting it, that would be in the back of the net. Or at least Valdez would have had to make an amazing save.
On the ball, rolling again for the second.
Either way, it is 1-0.
Make our way to Manchester.
Yeah, start the second half. Then coming straight to Royce. It is never good. Well, good for me. It's not good for them. Yeah, I don't give a shit what's good for them. It's off.
Antonio Valencia.
I think Chicharito is still with Man United in this. Correa.
That's good support as they build this attack.
Correa, ooh. Royce, Neymar.
Another shot.
Boom, 2-0. 21 goals. He is just on fire. There is no stopping Neymar in this form. He turns, he shoots, he scores.
Replaying over and over.
Daily Blind couldn't handle it. Not a lot of defenders on the planet who know how to deal with Neymar. If they did, Barcelona wouldn't be the best team in the world. Well, ladies and gentlemen, and that is a fact. Then again, Barcelona also have Messi and Suarez for people to worry about as well. That doesn't help that none of them are any bit alike in their playing style. They all have their own unique touches to their style. That makes defending against all three of them pretty much impossible. It doesn't help giving the ball away. He scores again, even though he slipped. 22 goals in the season. They must not care about top goal scorer because he assisted that one as well.
Ball passed it at the right time, he had no chance at all.
And even though he slipped, he puts it past Valdez. Without a second.
It had to be a brief one. He has told us that Spurs did score in that game. If you missed it, the score is now 3-0. A substitution, and it's Manchester United.
They've lost the ball again.
Very weak challenge.
Coutinho. Thought Neymar would be there. I tried to switch it to him, but switched me to the other man.
Antonio Valencia. Nathaniel Clyne.
Here's Bale. Puts it in. Is Neymar going to get the hat trick? Yes, he is.
And it's a perfect day for the player.
Were they just floating in midair?
There is a saying that things come in threes. They've come in threes for him. A hat-trick.
Maybe that would make... Maybe that's why I'm so unstoppable. All my players are apparently Superman.
This. Such a one-sided affair.
Oh. Neymar already has superhuman football ability, so he may as well be Superman as well.
And you can hear it in the lack of
right, wins the ball. Oh, this is going to get embarrassing now. Megan, it's 4-0. Not exactly every day, but we beat Man United 4-0. Neymar. Clear. To Tielemans! Did that come to Neymar? Jones gets there first.
For the corner.
Good thing he wasn't busy pulling one of his many faces to pay attention to what was actually going on. You know, just brought on Rojo, and I think they were bringing on somebody else as well.
He was on his toes.
Yep, they brought on Bastian Schweinsteiger. Oh, and they brought on Keane as well. Hey, all three of those substitutions at the same time. They'd be pissed off now if someone gets injured.
And coming up for you on EA Sports, that Premier League fixture.
Two rival matches in a row for Manchester United. It looks like following me, they play Manchester City here as well. So, Liverpool, then City. City will have a lot of confidence going into that match. They progressed to the semi-final of the Cap 1 Cup. And Man United have taken an absolute beating. Right. Well, Manchester City are doing any better, like. Well, Man City are. I think it's the fourth. Yeah, I think the fourth.
Manchester United needing a miracle here. Somehow they've got to try and get a rabbit out of a hat.
But, it's not like any team is going to catch me. Not when I'm in this kind of.
Signals for the throw. Ricardo Rodriguez. They've got the ball in the middle of the pitch here. Eriksen. Nathaniel
Klein can't get rid of it. Get rid of it. There we go. Royce gets rid of it. So we come to Eriksen. Don't want to see another late consolation goal. There we go. Keep a clean sheet this time. And no need to concede another late consolation goal. And it looks like Man United fans are both. But then again, Van Gaal, you staring at. Although, they cheered him when he did his little antics against Arsenal, so there's that. Maybe he can still get United fans on their side. Chelsea lost to Spurs! Chelsea dropped more points, brilliant! No one else except me seems to want to win this league. I'm the only one being in any way consistent. So, cheers, boy. It's awesome. Just a message when I've won the league so you can just, you know, just plan your summer break, you know. Go to beaches, get nice tans, you know. Not sure how that'll help you, but the league's been pretty one-sided for a few seasons now. Well, I'm sure they're not going to notice. So in the next episode, I have games against Bournemouth and Everton. And it's just, I'm just racking up the points, yeah? I mean, just look at that. From Spurs, who are in fourth, to Total City. I'm 20 points clear of Spurs and Newcastle. I'm 18 ahead of Chelsea. I'm 17 ahead of Arsenal. 17 points after 17 games. It's going to be another one-sided affair. I mean, look at that. I've only conceded 2 league goals. I've only conceded 3 goals in matches I've played this season. 3. The other teams just, they just can't compete. I'm just too good. Of course, that's why you watch me, because you can't and improve on being number one. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more. Or domination. And until next time, I hope you all have a very great night.